Identity and authentication. Okay. Okay. What is identity and triple A? Let me first write down this identity and triple A. So first, what is identity?
One question, Prem. Because today I have a meeting to tell some solutions in security on the network. And some new things about security and network. And could you tell me which are the new things that are now applying in the network? Is the one, for example, or something that is it, that could be interesting to I know that is not the is not relationated with the chapter of today, but could
you're asking SAEM? SAEM?
SAEM, what is?
What you're saying? SIM.
SIM.
What you're expecting? Tell me. In security, what?
Security or new things in networking. New technologies.
New technologies.
For example, now we have MPLS and VPLS and then I think anything else special, and I thought that SD-WAN could be
security new technologies, right? You're telling.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So
in networking, because
you want security or networking?
Networking, security, but applying to the network. If there are, for example, if the suppliers, if we ask for SD-WAN to the suppliers, this introduce something new in the network and something more security, no? Because at the end, you are putting firewalls inside of the network.
Understood. So basically, the latest thing what I am teaching to the now I have giving training to multiple corporate companies, right? So what the corporate companies are looking for? What they are? What is their? What is the current challenges?
Yes.
Current network challenges. So what are the challenges we are facing? Okay, now I can say like this. Nowadays, what is happening is we are coming for something called like, for example, if you take a WAN, right? Okay. Now see. Now, if you see nowadays, what is happening? data center. If you do it like this, okay, three areas. So what is the majorly current challenges, high level? Then WAN, what are the challenges we are facing? And what are the enterprise, what are the challenges we are facing? Data center, what are the challenges we are facing? Okay, now what is the solution for that? Now most of the companies, what their solution they are looking for, I'll write down, or what they are moving towards. So basically the current challenges now what we are facing is what is happening is the application centric infrastructure. What is that? In older days we used to see only service like a network services, right? So network services okay means all our network is fine, quality of service is fine. But now what is happening, they are worrying about not quality of service. Your network is working okay, but I want to see the application is working. So we are moving from quality of service to quality of application. Understand? So the net infrastructure is moving from network centric to application centric. Okay, it's a major challenge. Because of that, now they are saying, I don't care, your ping is okay. So like, for example, I say ping, now ping is okay, right? Ping 8.8.8.8. It's okay means it doesn't matter for me. What I'm expecting is ping is okay is not my problem. My problem is your application is okay or not. Understand? So network is fine, it doesn't matter for me. I want to make sure that the application is up and running properly. That is the first. Nowadays they are worrying about application centric infrastructure. The second thing is, now everybody is moving from on premises data center to cloud data centers, correct? So this is the problem. Next thing is, now everybody is moving their server rooms data centers to cloud data center. You're going to give cloud. So what is the problem here? Because of that, cloud applications are coming. Now cloud application means like Office 365 you are using, right?
Yes, we are using.
So Office 365, if you use, what will happen? Everybody is now accessing through, how do you access the Office 365? Through internet. Then my employees are actually my company organization traffic flow is completely changing now. In older days, there will be a branch, right? There will be a branch. Branch will connect through intranet. Intranet means, you know, right? What is intranet? Private WAN, right? Then it will come to data center. So from the data center, I will put a firewall. And then from the firewall, it will go to a internet, right? It was old. Now I want to protect my branch PCs. I will put a firewall so that the flow of the traffic is like this. From branch, you have a WAN, private WAN. From the private WAN, come to data center. In the data center, I'll put a firewall. Then they'll go to internet. So I can protect all my PCs through using this firewall. Okay. Now this was the flow, older setup. Now what is happening? Every branch is having internet at direct access to cloud applications like Office 365, right? Office 365, and they have intranet, they'll connect to data center. Then these people are having BYOD, bring your own device. Then they have guest internet. All guests will access to the internet. So like that, now the environment is completely changing. Now the environment is everybody want to access internet from the branch itself, because the applications are cloud applications, right? So the whole security flow is gone now. So where you'll put security now? You need to put security in this internet. Every branch you need to put a firewall. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
The firewall is not what we initially used to put only in the data center. We put a firewall and the flow was like this. But now what is happening? The all traffic is going like this. Because of that, the security become what we call, this is called a segmented security. Security fragmented, broken into small pieces. Fragmented security, and we don't know how, where, who is coming, who is going to attack our company. So we don't have control. We really don't have control. How do you protect the organization? Because everybody is bringing their own laptop, mobile phone, connecting to the internet. Through that virus is coming. So we really don't have any control on the nowadays it's happening. Understood?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Next is, we are going environment of what we call is because of this we need to have a more bandwidth, because everybody is connecting through internet now, so mm-hmm. we need to have more bandwidth you need, and complex operations are coming. Operations, right? These all are the current challenges. You got it now?
Mm-hmm, yes.
Now, what is the solution they are giving is for SD-WAN, for WAN, they are going. Basically, the solution is software defined networking. So we discuss about software defined networking. So we'll have a centralized SDN controller. So we'll control all the devices from central location. This is one solution. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
This is one solution where we control all the devices from central location. Just log into your controller. For example, here, if you log into, there is a Cisco, we have a product called Viptela. If you take that product, what will happen? They will give you a login for a vManage. Okay, you just need to log into this vManage, then you can manage all your WAN routers, WAN components. Understand? Central location. So this vManage will give you the comprehensive security. So this process solution is called SD-WAN. You got it now? So what is SD-WAN will do is, SD-WAN will do something called the intent-based networking. I try to understand this. Now this is the solution they are looking now, IBN. IBN. That is called intent-based networking means, now they will tell you, what is your requirement? Tell me. So intent-based networking has 3 points. Let me write down. IBN main aspects. So there are 3 points in IBN. Nowadays, the future is like this only. So what they do is they will use SDN. In the SDN, they'll give a solution called SD-WAN for WAN purpose. Now, what they do is they will actually use the, there's a concept called IBN. What is IBN is translation. Activation assurance. Now what is this? Basically they will tell you, boss, you tell me what is your business need, what is your business requirement, tell me, I will translate to technical needs. Step number one, all solutions will go like that. Now IBN based solutions. Nowadays, all solutions are coming like this. Second step is, now your technical needs are there, no? That I will not directly configure. What I will do, I'll convert these technical needs to policies. What I will do, I will log into this vManage and I'll create policies. I will create policies. So this policies will be and apply to devices. Now what will happen now because of these policies? Once you create policies and apply to the devices, all devices will have same policy. It's not technical now. So it's not only configuration. Now you tell, this is my organization policy. Your vManage will tell you to create a policy. Or your Cisco firewall will tell you to create a, your Cisco next generation firewall is there, no? That will create a policy. Anything you create a policy. Fortinet, you create policies, right? In Fortinet?
Yes.
So nowadays we are actually creating policies and we are applying policies to the devices, not configurations. Backend, what will happen? According to the policy, commands will be created. So, but as a user, as a technician now, as an engineer, we create policies, not configuration directly. We'll create policy and apply the policy. The last step is assurance. Assurance is visibility. Visibility of infrastructure. Now, whatever we have configured, is it really working or not? Then that is also what level? Application level. Quality of application level. So I can see that all applications are up and running. No delay. Everything is working fine. So this visibility you do. Proof. Like, yes, it is as per our design. It is working. So this is called what? WAN solution. Now enterprise, we have same way. SDN, so IBM based solution is there. The IBM based solution is called SDA. SDA means software defined access. Now if you go for these types of SDA in data center, we have for SDA, they use Cisco SDN switches. Okay, which will support the product, the controller is called you must have that switches you have to purchase. Then you have a Cisco SDN controller for enterprises. We have what is that? Cisco DNA as well as Cisco Meraki controllers. Meraki. These all are what? SDN based controllers. Meaning what? You log into DNA, you can manage your whole enterprise, okay, in one location. You can configure, you can troubleshoot, you can design. So if you see Cisco DNA, if you study, you'll understand. You can do everything from single location. Cisco DNA. See what it will do. Simplify them, increase the security, lower cost, transform your network. Applications to benefit intelligent optimization delivery, enterprise the application performance, network as well as application performance will check. So AI ML is integrated in this and it will support all the remote access, everything it can do in a single location. So this is the solution, the latest solution, Cisco DNA for enterprise. So in enterprise, if you want to go for advanced level, then you have to go for Cisco DNA. Same way, this guy, like we have another solution called Cisco SD-WAN, right? So Cisco SD-WAN, if you see, this is the one solution they are giving.
SD-WAN, so at the end is like a firewall.
Hmm? What?
Is like a firewall that,
yeah, SD-WAN, huh? SD-WAN. No, SD-WAN is not firewall. SD-WAN is you are moving your infrastructure from traditional networking to software defined networking. It's not only about security, okay? It's something like, you can see what is happening in WAN, what is happening to your application. You will get the security, full security you will get. I gave you different environment, like traffic flows are changing now, everything it will support. it'll give all the security for the different scenarios, guest VPN, guest LAN, or directly connecting to the service provider, you know, directly connecting to internet, all security this SD-WAN will give. Then SD-WAN will support your cloud-based applications, okay, i.e. SaaS application, whatever you are using, SD-WAN will support. And it is a cloud scale infrastructure. Tomorrow you want to upgrade it, all the devices will go to cloud. You don't need to maintain anything in your local on-premises. The SD-WAN is basically a solution for your WAN, where you are applying everything in is software defined. Means you just log into one location, you can see the whole WAN, your whole WAN environment in one screen, single pane of glass, we'll say, in one screen, and you can manage everything from single screen. It'll be very easy for you to manage. Automation is possible, performance will increase, you'll get direct internet access, brand security, multi-cloud access, these all you'll get in SD-WAN. You understand? So SD-WAN is not only security. Yes, it will give you security, but it is something like completely you are converting the traditional WAN to software defined, IBN, intent based networking. Understood? See, just understand like this. The future is IBN. Let me put here. This is IBN. And let me write it.
SD-WAN replace MPLS?
Mm-hmm. No.
No,
SD-WAN is not MPLS. MPLS is here.
Yeah, I know that is not MPLS.
Understand. MPLS is a WAN technology. Okay. MPLS is what? MPLS is a WAN technology. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, yes. What we are going to do is we are going to remove the control plane and management plane of all the routers, and we are going to bring that in a single controller, and we will configure, manage and troubleshoot everything from one location. I'll just log into one device, like for example, I'll show you. We manage home desktop. Otherwise, I will do one more thing. I have that. Just a moment. I'll show you one more thing. You'll understand what is the plan. What is that? We manage demo. Now start demo. Okay, now see, this is my just a moment. This is my this is my DNA. DNA is what? First, let's understand this point here. All are IBN, all are SDN solutions, software defined networking solutions. Okay, let me take this call. Just a moment. So all are SDN solutions, like IBN, that is the future now. So what we are doing here is we are actually bringing everything in IBN, intent based networking. So what is intent based networking? I told you, you will convert the business need to technical needs and convert into policies. And the policies will be and verify that what do you call activation. That is nothing but policies. Finally, make sure that it is happening. Assurance. You can see that visibility. So this is the solution. Now for that we have three things. One is for enterprise. What is the solution? Right? For van, what is the solution? For data center, what is the solution? So the future is like this. The future is you log into one screen. You will see everything in a single screen and all will take care of this. So you create a policy. The policy will be applied for everybody. Now, as of now, they created three domains. Like enterprise, they have a solution called SDA. The solution name is SDA, Software Defined Access. And for WAN, they call it as SD-WAN. The one they call SD-WAN. Okay. Now for data center, they call something called ACI, Application Centric Infrastructure. These are the solutions. For that, what are the all are SDN controllers only. What are the controllers we have? For SDA, we have we have something called Cisco DNA. I'll show you the screen, you'll understand. Cisco DNA. Same way for SD-WAN, we have screens like we have products called now this is the trend everywhere. Whenever I go and teach them, right, they ask, they in the latest company, every company, they are moving from normal networking to this SD-WAN networking, like SDN products. Like I take classes on SD-WAN, I take classes on SDA, I take classes on CACI. These are the classes I'll take nowadays. It's moving, all the organization is moving. And the controller is called, the SDN controller is called we call it as Viptela. We call it as Miracle. We manage one product. Or you can use another product called Miraki. Miraki. These all are the solutions Cisco is giving. For this is the solution is called APIC. The controller is called APIC. APIC is Application Policy Infrastructure Controller. So basically, what we are trying to achieve here is we are going for the future requirement. I told you the current challenges, right? All the current challenges will be solved by this solution. So this solution is giving you the this solution is giving you the answer for the all the current challenges. Now what is the problem we are facing? I told you. So this is the solution. Now you ask me question. You able to understand now? So what is the problems we are facing? For the problem, for example, WAN, you take MPLS. MPLS is a WAN technology. Now what is my problem is MPLS is not a problem. MPLS is there, but multiple routers are there, multiple devices are there, and the every branch is having internet direct access. So how do I secure that? So I need a central location. So I'll just log into one device. Okay, after logging to the device, I will able to manage all the branch communication, branch security. How I'll do it? So I'll create a policy for every branch. Understand? I'll add that policy to the branches. So then automatically my SDN, this Viptela, is we manage. He will take care of the security of each and every branch. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You able to understand or not?
Yes. I understand.
Okay. I'll show you some PPT. So you'll get more clarity on that, what I'm telling. So enterprise PPT SD-WAN. I'll give you some security examples. This is my SD-WAN PPT, what I prepared. Okay. I will show you that. What I'll show you security point of view. Now see. Now example. There is a user who is coming, employee who is coming from in data center directly. He want to go to internet, will go to data center and go. This is your PCI compliance traffic flow. And what our SD-WAN solution can give you, they will give you enterprise application awareness firewall and one IPS he will give. Okay, our SD-WAN solution will give. Now you tell this SD-WAN, your vManage boss, there are the policies like this. The users will go like this, but if any guest is coming, he can directly go like this. So for the guest, we can put a URL filtering. For guest access, we can put URL filtering. Extra thing you can add. This is supported in. So what you do, you create a use case like this, and you just put this use case in these branches. So there is a policy, like two policies are there. You put them. There is no guest option, means you just put this use case number one policy. Then there'll be no guest option in the in that branch. Now this branch is having a guest access, means you just put case two. Like that, we'll create two, three policies, and we will put the policy to the different branches according to the requirement. So this very clear cut design will be there, and there will be no confusion on the security point of view. So you can do everything in a single location. Now, if you are using direct cloud access, then you can go for extra security like DNS security. You know, DNA is umbrella, right? Umbrella is the product. So DNS security we can give. So like that, what will happen? The more and more you go, more and more complicated WAN solutions, the SD-WAN solution will give more and more security. Do you understand this?
Yes, but how do you do that? People, this guest, no, this or this employee. This employee, how access to this employee is in her home or in a branch.
Okay. Now what we do? We create something called VPNs. In SD-WAN, we segment the traffic through VPNs. Now you know VLAN, right?
Yes.
So VLAN, then we'll connect to VRF. You know what is VRF?
Yes.
Then, so for example, there are two traffic is there. One is employee, one is guest. So we divide that employee in one VLAN, guest in one VLAN, guest VLAN. Okay.
Yeah.
Now we will create a VRF for the guest VLAN and guest employee VLAN. We'll connect, we'll map the VLAN to VRF. Then this VRF we will map to this VPN number. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
So the traffic will go like this. I'll show you how the traffic will go. Okay. This is SD-WAN I'm teaching you, understand, right? So in SD-WAN, what will happen? We'll create a tunnel for each and everybody, IPsec tunnel. So the traffic will go separate like this, VPN 1. So what is VPN 1? I told you, VPN 1 is employee.
Inside of SD-WAN, there are different VPNs.
Tunnels will be, IPsec tunnels will be created. So what will happen? This is guest tunnel. Understand? Like that, I can create multiple. I can create 511 tunnels, VPNs. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
How many we can create? 500. So what will happen now? I can tell them, boss, your separate communication. So there will be no confusion. The guest we cannot go to your production network. Understood? He will directly go out to this VPN. He'll go to internet. He will not be able to go to production network. Clear?
Okay, but if you The ISP, no, the provider of the internet, they have to give you this SD-WAN. And if you are an employee.
No. It's not about internet. Understand here. It's not about internet. See, I'll show you the diagram. You'll understand. I'll show you the diagram. It's not about the service provider. You are telling MPLS, na? MPLS, you are getting confused, right? It's not about yes. MPLS or service provider.
Yes.
It is basically.
I confused with MPLS.
I understood. I'll show you that. I'll show you a diagram. You'll get clarity. So, it's not about service provider, okay? It's more on how you are going to manage your devices. Decentralized or centralized, understand? It's not about the WAN technology or WAN service provider. Are you able to understand what I'm saying? See, our SD-WAN solution is more towards SDN, software defined networking. Do you understand? See. Now this is your WAN routers, cloud, data center, campus, branch, small office, home office, right?
Yes.
This is your branch devices. Okay, edge routers. Okay. Now they all connected through different WAN technologies, internet, wireless, MPLS, doesn't matter. Okay, private or public, they all connected through different WAN technologies. You log into this vManage. And you'll manage all the devices. Now you use MPLS, internet or 4G, wireless 4G, 5G, doesn't matter. It is just a connectivity, transport protocols.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Here, what we are planning is, we are bringing the control plane of everything in this controller, and we'll manage this controller from a single location. I will log into this vManage, then I will configure all these devices. I will put policy for all the devices. Okay, I'll configure all the devices, same configuration. You know, central management. That is SDN. So SD-WAN, SDN or SD means what? Software defined means what? Bringing the control plane to central location and control managing that through a single screen. Understand? Okay. It's not about WAN technologies. You connect through any WAN technology, doesn't matter. It's called transport. Transport is not the problem. You're getting it right.
Okay.
You're able to understand?
Yes. Understand.
See, transport is not a problem for me. The thing is, it may be MPLS, 4G or internet. The only thing is, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to manage everything through a single management plane. I will log into this vManage. Then I will control the whole devices in a single location. Now, how do you connect these devices? Can connect the device through multiple transports. In SD-WAN, we support multiple transports. Understand? 16 transports you can support, not only 3. Up to 16 we can give. You understood, right?
Okay.
One of the technologies is MPLS. Is it clear?
Okay. Yes, it's clear.
So our goal is instead of manually logging to each and every machine and configuring, bring everything in a single location. You got it?
Mm-hmm.
I'll show you an example here. Now see, let me show you that. Just a moment. I will show you one thing. Then we'll go for our class. So what I was telling, let me finish that. So data center we have, same thing called EPIC. And the solution is called ACI. And the product controller is called EPIC. Okay, same way. So what is the concept here is? What is the concept here is? Basically, we are moving from traditional network to software defined network. Understand this? Software defined means what? Software defined means you are bringing everything to central location. So we'll have a centralized control plane, controller. Okay, then we do what? We do policy automation automation and programming. You understand now?
Mm-hmm.
So we will create a program, we'll upload to the controller. What the controller will do, the controller will automatically do all the configuration in 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Understood?
Okay.
If you manually go to each and every device and configure, no, it will take 1 week. You have, for example, you have 100 devices, 50 routers, 50 routers, 30 switches, you know, wireless access points. You have so many devices in your company. Now you want to configure everything, no? It will take 1 week to configure. But now what we will do, we will just go to the device called, for example, in enterprise, we go to DNA, Cisco DNA, and we will one shot, I can configure, I'll put a policy, I can add that policy to all the devices, then automatically all devices will configure in just 1 or 2 minutes. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
And we can automate also. If this any issue comes, you can send an alert to me. Like that, you can do automations. And you can programming also we can do. It is possible. Understood?
Yes.
Using JSON, Python scripts. Python scripts, you can create programming. And you can upload that programming. Instead of manually typing the commands, you can easily just upload that. And automatically within few minutes, it will happen. You got it now?
Mm-hmm.
It's called netconf. Netconf is the protocol. Netconf, Yang. This is the future. The future is what? We will just upload this script, Yang scripts, netconf scripts in this controllers. What the controller will do, controller will configure all the devices within a minute. Okay? We don't need any manually logging each and every device. This is called what? SDN solutions. Nowadays we are looking for. Because the complication is increasing daily, day-to-day basis. A lot of challenges are coming. So manually managing is not possible. So we are going to use controllers to manage our devices. You understood?
Mm-hmm.
Now I'll show you one example for a controller. This is one example. If it is working, I'll give the link also. You can also show them how the future will be there. Okay, to your organization. Okay, if it is working, I'll give that username password to you. Yeah. This is a demo controller to show you how the future will be calculated, how the future will be designed. This is some smart grid. They are managing a smart grid like that. All features are added in this. This is Cisco gave you one demo controller to just to show to the customer, your management, how the future will be there. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
So now this is the one controller which is going to manage your whole enterprise. Whole enterprise. You have hundreds of routers, hundreds of switches. No, it just manages the whole enterprise. So just what you have to do is in this, if you see this controller, what we can do is we can actually design your network, then put policy, provision, and verify that it is working fine or not. Then you can create workflows also. Workflow means whenever there is a message, next what to do, you can create automations. And there are a lot of tools for troubleshooting. You understand? And you can integrate with different, like for example, you have another tool, you can integrate that tool with this tool. Integration is for platform integrations are there. You can develop your own platform toolkit, is there. Through that, another application, this application talk to each other. You can set up the, third party integration. And you can create a reports, and it is the configuration of that. Do you understand this?
Yes, yes.
I'll show you an example here. So this is the assurance. I told you, no, assurance. You can verify mm-hmm. that anything goes wrong. For example, you have network devices, wireless clients. So you want to see what are the devices.
All of this is for management, but do you have to change your switches and your, you have to change all the infrastructure?
You need to change the switches for SD-WAN switches, SDN switches.
Yes.
Now you need to understand here. Now SDN base switches you need to change. Nowadays all switches are coming like that only. Okay, now you need to buy that switches nowadays, SDN solution switches. Okay, you need to upgrade to your switches. So I'll show you some so SDN, see, these are the things: SD-WAN, SD-Access, SD-WAN, SD-Branch. Okay, for example, this is data center. This is data center. Okay, this is the final concept. Now, for example, SD-Branch, you want to upgrade. You need to go for that branch switches you have to change. Okay. So this is the Cisco 5000 series. And this will support your everything, this solution. So you must have this devices. These switches, can you see the switches?
Mm-hmm.
So once you put these switches, then what you can do, you can directly log into this device. And that switch will send all the details to here. So from one location, you can see all the networking devices. And if anything goes wrong, router, core switch, distribution switch, access switch, controller, access point, anything problem, you can verify here. Okay. If any clients are going down, wireless clients or any clients, any issues are there, wired clients, wireless clients, you can verify here. Then application level, I told you, no, application level security. You understood?
Mm-hmm.
So this is assurance. Now you want to configure any devices, you can directly go to provisions, and you can just see the, for example, these are the services. All services are available. Cloud related also available. Like for example, let me see the inventory now. What are the devices this DNA is registered? I will go to global. Okay, I got some devices here. Okay, so this is my 3504. One device is the controller. This is a controller, and this is a switch. Okay, let me open that switch. What switch it is? Catalyst 96300. I think it's a data center 9K. Data center switches. Some data center switches are there. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So basically you can go to the switch, you can, it's a leaf and spine switch data center. So you can go to the switch and you can configure these devices. You understand? You can run some commands also here. Directly you can run some commands and troubleshoot. So everything can be done through single login. Just log into DNA, you can manage each and everything on the in the devices. You understood, right, what I'm saying?
Okay.
So this is called the future, how the your all devices, not only this, anything which you are connecting to the internet will be coming in this. If you go to a design point of view, you can design the whole building wise. Like for example, you can create a map, India world map. In the world map, you can say where is your office located. Offices are located globally, and you can actually click that. It will go to that location, that floor, that building like that. You can create the design of the physical design also, where you can put the devices in that. Understood, no?
Mm-hmm.
So this is design point. Then provision I showed you, assurance I showed you. You got the idea, no? Policy you can create. So these are different policies you can create. Application policy, IP based access control, group access control, you know? So different policy. So basically this is your trending now. Everything now, single location you log in and you manage all the devices. So this is the solution for our current challenges. So now you understood this?
Yes. Okay.
So I'll send you this. So if you want to tell about the trend, the future trend is, this is the future trend. SDN. And what is the solution? What is the benefit you'll get from this future trend? You can do automations. You can do what? Automation, everything can be automated. You can create a complete workflow. Daily morning, no, it has to check so many things and give me a report. If you configure like that, no, automatically this DNA will test all the devices, whatever you want to test, then it will give a report to you. Clear?
Clear.
You can create a workflow like this daily basis. It will verify and tell you. You got it now?
I got it.
So these automations are possible. So I send you the link. You can log in through and just see that links. Okay. The username password also I give. Devanati Cisco 123. And you got the answer, you?
Yes, yes, yes.
Friend understood, no?
Yes.
This is basically now it's moving. Everybody is going towards this centralized management systems. Everybody is moving software defined networking. They are actually changing their devices from normal device to SD-WAN devices. Got it, now? This is called the SD-WAN. So same way we have vManage, APIC, for everything we have the access. I've just showed you one at enterprise level. For everybody, every technology, every domain in our networks, slowly moving from normal network to software-defined networks. Automation, automation programmability is coming up. Clear?
Clear.
Okay, that's it. Now, what are the...
Thank you, Prem.
Yeah, yeah. Some articles I'll share with you. Now you'll understand the articles. So, rise of automotive hacking. Automation automatically happening, no? Rise of hacking. And these are the automation integrations. You want to see that? Automation integration. So most of the thing, mobile hacking, cloud-based hacking, right? 5G, internet, IoT hacking. You are understanding now, right? Automation, IoT, cloud-based hacking. These are the security threats, security trends. Now, because of automation, everything is moving to rise of automative hacking. Automatically hacking will happen. You got it, no? Insider threats means BYOD. I told you, like, nowadays the users are coming from inside also, bring your own devices because of the lot of insider hackings are happening. Understood? And the governments are fighting. Now, you know cyber warfare, right? You know what is cyber warfare?
Cyber warfare? No, I don't know what is.
You don't know? Okay, I'll show you that. See, what is happening nowadays is the people are actually started fighting. Government is started fighting through cyber. Now, there are different types of war is there. A older is called taking spear and shield and fight is old type. And then what came is atom bomb. Bombs they put, no? Hiroshima, Nagasaki. You know that?
Yeah.
That is one war, one type of warfare. So what happened was warfare, if you see, first was spear and shield. We used to take and fight, no? Then, then we have atom bombs. Now what we are going is bio war. Now what is bio war?
Bio
war means corona. We create small virus and we spread the virus. So what will happen? See, like for example, they are saying like China created the virus, right? So China is zero. Till that, there is nobody's have virus in China. They have maintained like that. Zero detection. Okay? You got the idea, right? Zero detection. So what will happen now? Now they are spread to all the world. Now it is hitting back to them. Now there it is hitting back. Okay, they are protecting in so many ways. That is called bio war. You create a virus and spread the virus to everybody. You got it?
Okay, yes.
So next is the last war is cyber war. Cyber warfare means what will happen is create viruses, worms, ransomwares, and spread all the world. Like for example, how do you access your bank account? Money. How do you transfer money? How do you buy some product in? You all use digital money, right?
Yeah.
Digital money. Digital, what is digital money, you know? Not physical. You don't use physical paper money, right? You use all credit cards, debit card, yeah. credit card, right? Nowadays you are using Ethereum only, right?
What?
Credit card, debit card.
Yes.
Okay. Now credit card, debit card is there, no? Now tomorrow what they do, the government will do is, suddenly they'll remove money from all the banks, credit card, debit card. If you swipe the card, there'll be zero amount in your credit card, debit card. You understand? Then what will happen? That will become a, that is something like a big, internally people will start fighting, they will go to the mall, they will take money, whatever possible they will collect, because nobody have money now, correct? In hand. You got my point, right? That is a war, it's called warfare. So now this is happening now, they started already. So for example, I'll show you an example here. You can see that it started. This is world, so US is attacking Netherlands, Spain, Taiwan, see, they keep on attacking now. New Zealand, can see that?
Yes.
So this is attack is started now. It's already going on all over the world, but still people are protecting. But at one stage, after this bio war is fully done, then this cyber warfare will become popular. Now it's not popular because we are not till faced it. End user is not facing any problem. But now end users started facing the problem, right? Like you lose your money, you lose your lot of things, right? A day-to-day basis, then it will be a problem. You got the idea?
Yes.
This is called a cyber warfare. What we call this? Cyber war. So we have to be ready for this warfare, okay? Next war it is. You understood? So they just make, to show your power, they will just attack you. Now see, New Zealand, they're attacking. US is attacking everybody. Can you see that? US is sending so many things to everyone. Okay. These are the attacks. In last day, Nepal is attacked so much. You got it, no? This is called cyber warfare. So these all are the top security attacks. Okay. This is one thing. Then I will give you network trends also. What are the latest network trends? Networking trends. So what are the networking trends? Araika is my friend, is working as a director. He is my staying with my flat, my apartment. He's the director of this Araika. Okay, now if you see. Now, cyber security, networking trends, I'm asking. So, yeah. SDN, I told you, right? Automation. First, they are saying that only. SDN and the automated networks. Multi-cloud technologies are coming. Hybrid network environments. Edge computing. 5G mobile is coming. Wi-Fi 6 is coming. Latest agile technology, Wi-Fi advanced. IoT, you know. IoT in the edge, IoT in the city, IoT in the retail service, IoT in the healthcare. Like the IoT is coming in multiple locations, and artificial intelligence lead for autonomous systems, and the SD-WAN will become a new standard. Okay, understood? This is the latest networking trend. Then we have intent based networking. I told you now, right? IBN, what is IBN? Intent based networking. Then wireless for drones is coming. Self healing networks, automatically their network will repair itself. I think that's it here. Now you understood, no? What is the future?
Okay.
I'll send you this link also. Okay, so you, based on this, you can submit to the management, correct? Enough, no input?
Yes, I have some ideas.
So you got the input, right? This input, you can submit to that. You can just tell this 21 points. They have given some points in this, no? Nice points are the security points, networking trends. Okay, so mainly it is moving towards IBN, intent-based networking. Yeah, SDN and IBN, remember that. This you remember, SDN and IBN. Okay. You understood, no?
Yes.
So there is a controller. The controller is called SDN controller. SDN controller. Okay. And these are the devices. Router, switch. Okay. Wireless access points. Okay, wireless access points, wireless controller, server, okay, like this. So now we have different devices, like server, PC. Now all the company, what all things you have in a company, I put here. Okay, now what will happen? There will be different ways to attach these devices. Okay, like different ways to attach to the devices. Now we have different technologies. Like you, how do you connect these devices? You connect through internet, you connect through MPLS, you connect through wireless, you know, that is called the transport. So internet, MPLS, or you use 5G, 5G, 6G wireless. Okay, understood? No, these are connecting, you're connecting. So basically what will happen? You connect through all these things to a single device. And this is connected to everybody. You're understanding, right?
Mm-hmm.
So everyone is connected like this. So these devices, now what you do, you log into these devices and you log into these devices and you will manage from a central location. So you log into this device controller. Okay, and then log in and manage. From, we call this as a single pane glass, meaning one location, you only one login you do and you manage all the devices. You can, what all you can do, you can do design translation, let me put it another way, design provision. You remember this we saw in this one in DNA, design, provision and assurance, and remember that. So we can design the whole network, we can give provision that what are devices to be added. After adding that, you can verify that everything in a single location. You can log into that and see that in a single desktop, like you can create your own dashboard. From the dashboard you can see all the details. We can publish, put the dashboard in your NOC video wall. Understood, no? So this is your future plan. So because of this, what will happen? We will be getting automation, programmability is possible. Automation and programmability is possible. You can actually integrate all third party applications. So for example, you have 10 applications. You know what is DevOps, right? What is DevOps?
DevOps.
You know what is DevOps?
More or less, yes. Developing.
Okay. We will study that. I think we have the topic here. In software development, is there, na? We have a topic, okay? In that we will learn, okay? If it's not there, I'll teach you. Okay, so DevOps is a one technology where we will actually integrate the whole communication. I'll show you an example. So to do DevOps, software development, no? Software development, you need to use, you must have SDN network. Generally, you can run DevOps, okay? DevOps is one method of one way of developing the applications to run the application. But to do that, you need you need SDN network. Understood? If we don't have SDN, we cannot run DevOps. You clear?
Clear.
So what is DevOps? DevOps is nothing but everything is automated. Did I put this 500? Yeah. Everything is automated. DevOps, I'll show you. Now, in a company, you want to develop an application. What will happen? You need to have what all the different technologies are there. Now see, DevOps is you are taking care of the development, application delivery and operation. All three will come single location. Do you understand?
Okay.
Now we are going to use these applications. MS Office and connect to the Git. Git will go to Jenkins. Jenkins will go to Puppet or Docker or Kubernetes. Then it will come to this one. What is that? Jira, Mantis. Then you can verify that. You understood this? These tools automatically talk to each other. You don't need to configure anything. You just create that in MS Office. Automatically, the Office 365 automatically go to GitHub. It will automatically go to Docker to Puppet. It automatically update in your. You understand, right? Continuously, it happens. This is called the DevOps environment. This is one software developer environment that is coming up. All these things are coming up in future. So the future is this, like this only, it will be there. So for that, we need what we need for all these things. We need what? SDN. Because SDN is the base. You understood now? This is automation. Everything will be automated. You don't need to do in world days. How what will happen is first you develop your coding. No, you have to send the, you have to test the coding, then send to another department. They will integrate that coding. Then they will deploy. Another department will deploy that software in a server. Another department, there are 10 departments will be there like that. You understand? It will take 1 month to implement one software application in a real time. But now just like that, just update it. Within 2 minutes, it will come. Understood this? You just develop the code in the GitHub, automatically go to Maven, automatically go to Selenium. It will verify the Selenium. It will release in the Jenkins. Then it will implement in the Amazon Web Services, AWS. Then you can verify that in Chef, operate that in Chef and Kubernetes. After that, you can monitor from Splunk. Our Splunk is there, na? Splunk, you can monitor that application, how it is working fine. Then if any issues, you can again upgrade to the Jira. This is the flow. Automatically, it happens. To do all these things, what you need is, you need the Splunk has to be connected to the integrate with the Ansible. You understood? So Splunk is we are using day-to-day basis, right? For SOC, soccer. So the same Splunk will be integrated with this. When Ansible will give input to the Splunk, Splunk will do what he wants to do. Understood now?
Okay.
This is automation. Everything is automated now. Jira will talk to Maven. Maven will talk to Selenium. Selenium will talk to, for example, Jenkins. Jenkins will talk to Docker. Okay, Docker or AWS. AWS will talk to Kubernetes. Kubernetes will send it to the Splunk will directly send anything. If you want, you send it to Jira again. Continuously, it will happen. This is called what? DevOps. Understand DevOps?
Yes.
Basically, DevOps is automation culture. We are developed now. Now everything is automated. Nowadays, all the software development is happening like this only. We don't do manually doing the testing on all these things. Automatically, everything happens. Just create a code and it'll happen. Okay? Do you understand?
Yes, yes.
Like example, if you see, I'm having my website. I don't know if it will work or not. Okay, let me check like this. There was one editor, yeah. See, not picto chart. Okay. Now see, this is my website. Okay, so this website I will log in now. How much time it will take to update in the real time? You know, just a minute. I can change anything in my website. You know that? Because this website is based on DevOps environment. So within 2-3 minutes, I can configure my website. Coding will be written, tested, uploaded in my cloud. Within 1 minute, it will be published in the internet. So my website will be updated. Do you understand? This is called what? DevOps environment. So all these things are coming based on the latest technologies. So that's it. These all are the latest technologies now we are using, and the trends what we are using. I think I gave some useful answer. You got some idea?
Yes.
Okay, see, this is my website. I have developed my website now. In older days, what I have to do, I have to write the code, new code. After writing the new code, what I need to do is I need to submit to the developer. Developer will test the code. Any bugs are there, will correct it. After correcting the bugs, he will upload that code in the server. Then that will come to the production. So it will take almost 1 or 2 weeks to do any changes in the website. Understand? In older days. Now the website development is just like that. I have a editor. I will just log into the editor. I will just change whatever I want to change. I'll just click publish. Publish means automatically this screen will create the code, put the code in the GitHub, and GitHub will send it to another Selenium. Selenium, it will automatically. You understand, right? Automatically everything will be done within 2 minutes. For example, this Facebook page is there, na? Like, for example, I'll put something like I'll make it bold. Bold kar denge isko. Okay, bold ho gaya. Bold. Now see, publish. That's it. Now what will happen? Within a minute, my change will be updated. Coding is updated. Now I can go check in the website. You got it? My Facebook page become bold. This is my website. So this is called DevOps. So the whole development process is becoming automated. Because of that, within a second, I can get the, within a minute, I can get the whole thing ready. You got it now?
Yes.
This is called the DevOps environment. So this we will study. We have 20-21 chapter now. We have some topics in that. We'll see that time. But this is your latest trend. That's it. I think I covered. Okay, any other doubts you have?
No. Thank you for the.
Yeah, no problem.
Masterclass. Thank you for this masterclass.
This help you when you are going for a real time. Actually, what I told you is, see, book is something what I am experiencing. Working in real time is something, right? Book is always theory, more theory, not much practical experience examples. This is what I told is what I am really doing daily basis in my custom with my customers. Okay, this customers, I'm working with multiple customers, you know. So what they do, like Air Force is also moving to SDN. I'm going to Air Force training now, Indian Air Force. Indian Air Force also moving all, they're removing all the old switches. They're putting SDN switches. They are moving to SDN. DNA. Understood?
Yes.
You got it. No, I can't show you the PPTs because it's confidential, right? Air Force, I can't show you. Okay, but you got it. No, I have PPTs for Air Force also, but I can't show you in this. You got the idea?
Yes, I got
an
idea.
So I will not show outside because that is a confidential. I can't show outside. But they are also moving to SDN, all these things. Everybody. Okay. I think done. So let's just run through. An half an hour is there. We'll just run through some basics in this. I think you will understand this. It's not a difficult topic. Yesterday also I told you. It's just run through this. We'll take some questions directly. If any doubts, we'll come back to this chapter. It's a very simple chapter only. Okay. Understand? It's not a difficult chapter. It's like identity and what is identity?
Identity is to identify who are using some service or identity.
Now, identity means, yes, based on some operating system service, we call this as a profile and posture. We will set a profile. If that device is not according to the profile, you will not get that device is not allowed inside the network. Understand? Like example, OS, applications, some security patch, and all these things, antivirus, anti-malware. You understand? If these applications are not there, that laptop is not allowed inside your network. Understood? That is called identity services. Then what is authentication? Who can access? What is authorization? What can be accessed? What can be accessed? Okay, what is accounting? What is accounting? What is accounting is logs, logs, what you did. Okay, clear? You yes. Understood this?
Yes.
Now let's go to the topics in this. So there are different types of access management. Is there physical as well as logical? So what all you're going to protect from the access management, information system, devices, facilities, we're going to protect. And we have different types of multi-factor accountability session. We'll see one by one. So let's go to this chapter. Information system, devices, facilities, personal. These are all the things we're going to includes the asset. Asset includes the information, systems, devices, facilities, and personnel. Even people also, asset only. Understand? What is asset? Asset is all four. Information, systems, device, five. And personnel also. Facilities and personnel. Now, what is the subject and object? You know that we already studied the subject and object. Subject is active entity. Object is a passive entity. A subject is going to access the object. Object is the one which is getting accessed, like resources, what are used, accessed is object. We studied that. CIA, you know, already we studied. Identity, authentication users, we studied. Okay, monitor records, yeah, the same thing. Preventive control, detective control. Preventive means you prevent from the attacks. You use before logs, biometrics, preventive man traps. Preventive, detective means just seeing the attack is happening, like CCTV camera. CCTV camera is detecting only, it's not actually preventing. Corrective is after the attack happens, you correct that. How do you correct that? Stop the attacks. Like you put some quarantine, put them in the quarantine when correcting purpose, taking a backup, restore plan or quarantine, corrective controls. Deterrent controls is just creating an environment saying that discouraging the people not to do the activity. Like I told you an example, like you are putting a security awareness trainings, locks, fences, batches, guarders. So these all cameras will show, see that people will discourage to do the any wrong things. Recovery accesses, if anything goes wrong, you recover them using fault tolerant drive systems, imaging, clustering, antivirus, like these all are recovering, shadowing. And directory access controls are nothing but you can correct, directly control the system, then through the system, directly access controls. Compensation is when something goes wrong, you put another one to compensate it. Administrative controls are, you are having this policies, procedures, hiring, background check, all these policy administrative controls. Logical controls are, you know, these logical controls like your devices like firewall, routers, intrusion, things, logical controls. Physical control, you know that locks, biases, docks, everything is physical control. That's it. comparing identification and authentication. So identification, I told you, the identification is basically process to processing the identity. Authentication is the subject comparing with the multi-factor database. So authentication is basically to see that you are a right person or not. But this is identifying is the claiming I am that person. Okay, claiming the identity is identification. After claiming, proving that you are the person is validating is authentication. Registration and proofing, you know, identity. HR has ID card, identity, registration, proofing. Authorization, accountability, you know that. We discussed about that. Same thing. Now, three types of authentication factors, you know. Type 1, type 2. Type 1 is like something you know. Type 2 is something you have. Type 3 is something you are. You know this, right? You, these three, you know, right? Type 1, type 2, type 3.
Yes, we are searching some solution to put here the double factor.
So dual factor, okay. Content based, many mobile devices, we have content based authentication. So MDM, so what content you are using based on that, you'll authenticate. Geolocation and technologies are there. So all these things we can use. Content context based authentication is there. Passwords, you know, password storage. We studied that. Maximum age, complexity, length, history, faces, consecutive passwords.
One question in multifactor. For example, if you decide to use a token with cryptography or a card with cryptography in Windows, you can use both at the same time. Login user and password and use a card. You have to use one or the other for
basically you understand here. There are two things here. Type 1, type 2, type 3 means something you know, something you have, something you are, something you wear. Like that you can remember four. So when you say something you know, then you need to go for next type is something you have to use. Don't use both same, something you know. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
So now authentication can be something you know, then next you have to do something you have. Right? So now that is the best solution. Now what you are saying is you are going to use what? One is, what is the PIN number? What are the two factors you are telling now?
Yes, PIN and a card, a certificate card or token certificate.
No, certificate is not authentication. Certificate is something okay, but you're going to use token?
Token, yes.
See, token is token what? Token is again something you know, have. Right? You have.
Token is you have means you have.
How do you get the token? You are going to give some RSA generators.
Yes.
You have this. See, there is something called RSA. I have seen this. This you are going to give like this.
Yes.
That is something you have. You must have this, right? Then this number you can use it. Okay, yes. This is fine. You can go with this. Something you have, something you know, something you have. Third, if you want, you can give thumb also. Something you are.
Yes.
Like third.
But something you know, you have to put PIN to this. You know, somewhere. I thought that for Windows, you can use your login and password, and a part of this, this key, this card or this USB.
Token, no? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, but not. It is not again your password. It is. It will generate that time what you must have that physical device in your hand. Right, then that is okay. Fine. Do two types. One type one, type two. It's okay. Good. You can go for these two factors. Okay. okay, type 1, type 2 you can use.
Okay.
Okay, that's good, good design. So I have seen multiple companies are using this. One is a hardware token, not software, okay? Software means again goes inside this, something you know it will go. Understood, right?
Yes, yes.
Don't do that. So use the hardware token, so it will become as you have. You must have that token device. Understood, no?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So then we will go to this. This is clear. Passwords, password storage, maximum age, we saw that. Then cognitive. Cognitive means it will ask you a lot of questions like this. Then you give the answer. That is cognitive. Smart cards and tokens. We just know we discussed about smart card, credit card, all these things. Okay, tokens is there. So synchronized dynamic password tokens, asynchronous password tokens, one-time password generators, two-step authentication. Just now we discussed about two-step authentication and hash-based code password. Nice. Time-based one-time password. Okay. Biometrics, fingerprints, face scans, retina scan, iris scan, palm scan, hand geometry, heart pulse, voice recognition, voice pattern, signature dynamics, keystroke patterns. I have seen walking also. You seen that walking, they will detect and put that?
Keystroke patterns?
Not keystrokes, walking. In that movie, mission possible. What is that? And one is there, that walking access control. You can see this is you see.
Uh-huh.
He will walk, okay. Actually, so based on the walking, they will decide this is good guy, same guy, different guy.
Ah.
You seen that? You seen this scene? You have seen the security scan? It's a very good design. So I have seen that in
Yes, okay. It's clear.
So it's a very nice design actually, where they will show you this is one of the access control, nice access control. This is one type one access card. You are something you have. The next is something you are. Something you are is this is the way they do. Okay, you can see.
Okay.
That's it. This is one thing. Biometric factors, false rejection rate, false acceptance rates. So basically, this rejection rate, acceptance rate is when you are actually using biometric, right? You are showing you are going to take multiple times the biometric. You seen that when you are going to register your thumb drive, you will do multiple times. You know, right? Why you are doing multiple times? You know. When you are actually putting your thumb impression in your mobile phone, you do multiple times. You know, right?
Yes.
Why we are doing is there is a rejection rate, acceptance rates. For example, 60% is matching, you accept it. Less than 40% is rejected. Okay, it has to match minimum 60%. That is called a false rejection, false acceptance rates. Understood? That's why we are placing multiple times the fingerprint. Got it, no? So yes. We will set a rejection rate. Now if it is same or equal means it is a danger. Okay, so this is something like this. So false rejection rate, false acceptance rates, there is something called equal rate. Equal rate means both are same, exact place. Okay, that is a danger. You must not have equal rate. Got it, no?
Okay.
So this is the major thing in a biometric registration. So more and more you go for. Otherwise, people will easily break that. What hacker will do is, hacker will try to find the exact meeting point and he will try that and break through that, go inside that. You understand? Like a false positive, false negative will create. You understand, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this is the false, it's called it as exactly setting the CR level. So this is one thing, biometric registration, you know, multi-factor authentication, device authentication, service authentication, you know, implementation of implementing single sign-on, you know, LTE, LDAP and centralized access, PKIs, public key infrastructures, Kerberos we discussed, key distribution center, key authentication center, ticket granting, ticket. These all are basically Kerberos, how Kerberos works. The user types a username password to the client encrypts the username password with the AES for transmitting the KDC. KDC verifies the username and database, known credentials. KDC generates a symmetrical key that will be used to client as a Kerberos server. It encrypts this with a hash or user password. The KDC also generates a encrypted time-based ticket. Okay, now KDC transmits that encrypted symmetrical key to the ticket to the client. The client installs that TGC and to use until it expires. The client also decrypts the symmetrical key and hash the user password. Now you understand, when a client wants to access the object, it is connected. Now it requests the ticket to the Kerberos server. The ticket following steps are followed. The client sends the ticket back to the KDC with the request of accessing the resources. The KDC verifies the ticket is valid, checks the access control, the process, and KDC service ticket is sent to the client. So the client sends the ticket to the server for servicing hosting the resources. The server hosting resource verifies the validity of the ticket. Once the identity authorization is verified, Kerberos activity is completed. The server host opens the session. Client begins to the data transmission. You understand now? This is the flow. Actually, we are discussing about Kerberos, right? This is the exact flow of Kerberos. That's why Kerberos is more secure. We have a ticketing server. Ticketing server will give you a ticket. So using the ticket, you have to get authorized based on the identity and ticket. Then only it will allow you to access the server. Understood?
Okay. Yes.
Kerberos is compared to NTLM. Kerberos is more secure because of this process. Then your single sign-on, you know. All these things we discussed already. Then high HTTP, HTML, XML, SAML, all of some markup languages where you create your Port 02, OpenID, web application protocols, scripted, centralized management systems, SSO, integrated services, managing sessions, okay. AAA protocols. What are the protocols we have?
Do you think that single sign-on is secure or not?
It depends on the company organization policy it is. I generally say that it is okay, but there are some places they say no, we don't want single sign-on, we want separate. Okay, what we can do is we can take something like day-to-day operations are there, no, daily operations. For them we can use single sign-on, but for special servers which you are not going to connect daily basis, that you can keep it separate sign-on. Understand? See, what is the purpose of single sign-on? Daily basis, I don't want to give approval, right? Every time I don't want to authenticate again and again. That purpose, you can go for single sign-on. You got it, no? But yes. There are some important servers. I want more security. Let them keep separate. You got it, no? Don't add that in single sign-on process. But daily you are not going to log into that. It's very, very critical applications or critical servers. You keep it separate sign-on. Daily basis you are logging, like email you are checking, you know, daily you are checking email deal. So that things you can give it single sign-on. You got it, no?
Yes.
That is my policy. It depends on the organization policy. But if you ask me, I will say that you don't waste that concept. It's a good concept. Don't waste the concept. It will ease your daily operations. You got it, no? Make sure that will not affect your critical servers. But if you want, you can keep separate login, double login for that. You need a OTP for that. You understand, no?
Okay.
So, you know, AAA firewalls, there are different firewalls. There are different protocols are there in AAA, like Radius, DECAX, we discussed about that already, Diameter. So building on access, Diameter was developed, name called Diameter. Enhanced version of Radius is called Diameter. It's another protocol. Diameter uses some enhanced version of radius is called diameter. Okay, is another protocol. Yeah, that's it. Now you understand that there is a life cycle. How the identity and access provisioning will happen. It's not a fixed activity. It keeps on changing. So you need to understand that when you are provisioning the access. Okay, when you are maintaining the access account review, you are doing very dangerous. You must remove the when you are they're not using it. For example, revocation. What is revocation? If somebody leaves from your company, you have to remove all the access from them, right?
Mm-hmm.
Don't remove, what will happen? They will tell you are terminating the employee. No, you must have a proper process to remove all the access. Okay, that is about account revocation. That's it. Clear, na?
Yes, more or less clear.
Yeah, you have done. Now, what is there? You want to discuss anything in this?
No.
I think it's all more on very basics only. We already discussed about TechAx, radius, diameter is a new protocol. The advanced layer, the advance of TechAx, radius. Radius protocol, that's it, nothing else. Rest all we have discussed. Let's go to the question. If any doubts are coming, we'll come back.
Okay.
If you have any doubts, you can ask me.
Mm-hmm.
Let's start the question now. It's a small question, small topic only. It's not a difficult topic. Now let's start.
None of the above, only facilities, these facilities.
Correct answer. Which of the following could not be accessed? So none of the above. Could not, all are assets only. So there are actually five is there, information systems, devices, facilities, and personal. Personal is not added. Okay, all are assets. So answer is, write down the answer.
Yeah.
Okay, no, correct. No. Next question.
Which of the following is true? Subject. C, no?
Correct answer. See, now what will happen when you do the next chapters, no? Repetition will come. Because when I take a topic, I don't think it's only that topic. I'll cover all the related topics, correct? So what will happen? Repetition will come again and again. That's why I'm going very fast. So most of things we already covered. So again and again, we are just clearing the doubts and moving forwards. When you come to software security also, you can see that we have covered DevOps now, right? When you come to software security, it will be easy for you to understand software. Got it, no? So that's like that only. That is my way of teaching.
Mm-hmm.
So now last chapters will be very faster.
Okay.
Which of the following types of access control uses fences, security policies, awareness training, antivirus? Yeah. Unwanted occurring. So antivirus stopping.
Preventive.
Which type of hardware, which type of access controller, hardware or software? Stream? Hardware and software. So what we call that? Hardware and software. Softwares, hardwares, what we call that type of security control?
Logical, technical.
Yes, correct. Next, correct. Okay. Okay. Yeah, okay. What is login ID?
Authentication.
No, no, authentication is password.
Login ID. Identification.
Correct. Correct. Correct.
Identification.
Mm-hmm. Accountability requires all the following item except one. Which item is not okay for accountability? Accountability.
All of the following items.
Accountability requires two things. One is identification, then is authentication. Okay, authorization is not comes under accountability. Understand? What is accountability? What is accountability?
Accountability, it was the logs, no? The logs of the...
Okay, you are thinking like that. Mm-hmm. Accountability means basically who can log it, who is accountable for this action. Correct? Who is accountable for this action? Who is the account manager? Who is accountable for this? In which name this, say for example, somebody is working on your in the project. If the project goes wrong, from who will be accountable for that? Which employee? It's called accountability. Understood?
Okay, yes, yes.
So for that, we need to know two things. Identification, authentication will give accountability.
Mm-hmm.
Got it, no? We'll use that accountability for logging, auditing purpose.
Okay.
Next.
What can you use to use it from rotating between password, password complexity, password history, password age, No? No.
What can
prevent
you use to prevent
from rotating?
Rotating.
Password history. Password history.
Correct, correct. You don't want to put last three passwords, you know?
Yes, yes.
History. The next. Passphrase.
To remember.
Yeah, correct.
Something you have.
Yes. Something you know is one. Something you have is two, something you are is three, something you wear is four, but nowadays four is okay with Nantar. Only three we discuss generally. Geolocation also coming nowadays. Okay, now 11.
Okay. It was asynchronous token or synchronous, I don't know.
Tell me. So synchronized token means it generates and displays one time password, which is synchronized with the authentication server. Asynchronous token means it will use as a challenge. It will generate a challenge, okay? You need to match the challenge with the one time password. Understood? So the question here is, the server hosted with organization's password, what is the password given to time? So what type of device it is? So here, the answer is it's not a challenge. It is not giving a challenge. Understand? It is not giving a challenge. What is asynchronous token? When you give a challenge, you have to match the challenge. It's not the same password it is matching. Understood? You know CHAP, right? CHAP.
Yes.
What is PAP-CHAP difference?
It was in plain text or it was encrypted?
No. PAP is a plain text password, correct? CHAP is, it will generate a hash code. What it will do?
Okay.
CHAP will generate a hash code and send the hash code to you. You have to generate the hash code and match that. If your hash code and whatever receive hash code is matching, then the challenge is success. Then you'll get the authentication. Understood? Challenge handshake authentication, you know, right? So in challenge handshake authentication, the router will not send the password. It will send what? Using the username password, generate a hash code. It will send the hash code. You understood, right?
Yes.
So CHAP is? PAP, CHAP. You see? What PAP will do is, it will generate a, it will send a challenge. It will using the username password. Then it will also generate the same username password. It will generate the hash code. If it is matching, it will accept or reject. Understood? This is CHAP. Same way, synchronous token means the authentication server and the user will have same token. They'll receive the token. It will match and allow. Understood? There is synchronous token. Asynchronous token means it will generate that, it will not have a same username password, same password, same token, password will not be there. It will generate a challenge. It will send a challenge. If challenge is success, then it will accept. Understood? So okay. Smart card do not generate one-time passwords. Smart card is ruled out, and common access card are a version of smart card only. So both are ruled out. So the question is what here? The question is, devices generated one-time password for every 60 seconds. So what we call that? That is a synchronous. Understood? Okay. Asynchronous will, what it does is it generates a challenge response process. You understand, no? It generates a challenge. It's not generate a one-time password. Next. Physical. Next. CER, I told you. CER is the, okay, what does the CER for biometric devices indicate? Indicate means, CER means exactly equal. Understand? What is CER full form? Crossover error rate. Meaning both your false rejection and false acceptance is matching one location. It's equal, right? So for example, you are saying your thumb, the fingerprint is there, no? Fingerprint is 80% is false rejection. Now you say false acceptance is 20%. There is a place to 81, both will match. You understand? That is your equal point. That is called crossover error rate, where the error will happen. Both are same. So what is the question here? What does the CER for biometric indicates? Indicates the sensitivity is too high. The sensitivity is too low. It indicates the point where the false rejections equals false acceptance rate. When high enough, it indicates biometric device is highly accurate. So what is the answer here? What is CER? You remember the graph, right? Do you remember that graph? We have seen one graph.
Yes. Yes. It's a point.
Like one graph came now, like this. So what is the topic is CER. So got this, right? This is the copy. Just remember this graph. So what is CER is false acceptance rate and false rejection rate. both are matching one location, no, equal. Like for example, you say your pin, your mobile phone fingerprint is done, no, biometric. It is 60%. You accept it, no problem. No. If it is more than 80%, please reject that. Don't accept that as authentication. So the sensitivity, understand? Mm-hmm. Now both are matching from one location. That is called equal crossover error rate. They both are equal. Understood? The question is this. What is the question now? The question is, what is CER means? Yeah, answer.
See.
Yeah. Clear?
Yes.
Okay, next. Sally has an user account, has been logged in on the user biometric system. Today the biometric system recognize her, so she is able to log in. What describe this? What is the issue here?
False rejection.
Correct. False rejection. Correct answer. So sometimes it will reject false, like a false negative, you know. It's a type 1 error. Next. What is the purpose of Kerberos? Yeah.
Authentication.
Yes. What is the best solution for your federated identity management, FIM, in HTML, XML? What is the best solution? Security level, tell me.
Security level.
Like federated identity management means like a single sign on all these things.
Which of the friends?
So basically, security point of view, what is more secure?
What, sorry?
Security point of view, what is more secure? For
Kerberos.
No. For this is basically for single sign on all these things. So Kerberos is not for that. This is basically your XML based graph, you know, website based HTML, XML, you know. See, what is federated identity management? You understand here something like you are logging to a web page. From the page, web page, if you log in, you'll get access to everybody. You see that type of login, like Cisco login. You've seen Cisco login.
Yes.
Cisco, when you log in, no, you'll get all the one option will come. You'll have single sign on there. Cisco login. Right. I'll go to here. I'll log in here. Right. So this time, this is federated login, integrated login. Understand? This one. Mm-hmm. Now for this, what is the best solution you think? Which best protocol? This is not for Kerberos. This is basically XML, HTML, okay. XML website. The question is more on web page.
Security.
So answer is
security.
Security.
Okay.
Yes.
Amen.
Understood? No.
Okay. Yes.
See, HTML will use. Tell you only data displayed. XML is used for defining tag, but Kerberos supports single organization, not a federation. Okay, what is federation? Okay, first of all, you don't know what is federation, right? Let me tell you what is federation. Federation meaning group of states with central government, you know, multiple organizations. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
Now, Kerberos is okay for a single organization. For federation means multiple people you are going to log in. Understand? You are going single sign on. Understand? For that, you have to use this one. SAM. You got the point, right? Between organizations. Okay. Federation means what you understand here? Between two organizations. Clear?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Now your company and another company, you're going to have single sign on. Then you use this protocol. Clear na? What is federation management? Understood, no?
Yes.
Okay, next. Yeah, this you can easily answer.
authentication server. Function server. Server.
What is the function of a network access server within a within a radius architecture? So what do you say?
C. No.
C is AAA server. What is network access
server?
What is network access server? Okay, let me put this diagram here. You'll get a clarity now. This is a radius server. It's not asking radius server. It is asking something called network access server.
Don't worry, Prem, because it's very late and I have to. I have some colleagues that are typing messages, and I have.
Okay.
I will study.
Okay. So I'll just show you that. We'll finish it now. So basically, this is the one. See, there is a network access radius server, network access server, then machine. This is your client. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
The answer is client.
Fine.
Then this is the protocol. What is the typical protocol based on radius and mobile IP? That is
diameter.
Diameter is a new one. The last one is, which are the basic principles relating the deploy employment? Least privilege.
Okay.
Principle, you know, right? Least privilege. Then what is the last one? What account is this account to be employed? Account review. Clear?
Okay.
So we finished one chapter today. So we will take the next chapter on. When is the next class? It will be 15. On
15th.
Yeah. 15. Okay. 14th. Okay. I'll give you a 14th. I will just message you in the WhatsApp. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Take care. Bye.
Bye.
Take care. Bye. Thank you.